Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our first ever day of the Watch Along. This is Sunday. Resurrect is back. We have at least 2 more days till we hit WrestleMania, right? However, we have the last bit, the last main anime, which we are probably watching like at least 28 episodes. But today we'll be watching this 10 episode of Frieren Beyond Journeys End. So guys, the end of your day, and I cannot wait. Guy, I'm Kirby, I'm
Poppy,
and I'm Neo.
And I'm Don, and I'm Sana, and I'm Akama, and for a weekend, I'm charged the almost 40 MA demo. And guys, today is going to be a special day because for those who watch our solo and Dirty Hard, we'll see you guys on Tuesday for our last day of Frieren Beyond Journeys End.
Actually, no, solo and
Dirty
Hard will be coming on Tuesday.
Well, like I said, it's coming Tuesday along with Frieren Beyond Journeys. But hello, guys, this is Saturday, and we know tomorrow Easter Sunday was a wreck. And for those who celebrate Easter, hope you had a good time with this year Easter, because we know that the next day we'll be headed to Watch Along WrestleMania. Guys, keep believing that this Monday is Watch Along WrestleMania. 2 weeks of spectacular we will never see. Plus, don't forget, Stan Deliverer, which coming up, we'll get more details on the way during the rest of the week.
I cannot wait We got the new people that the new enemy called them. And then, new season 2 of death, which is 3. And then, we got, of course, this trilogy. And then, we got more Molokar and then Return coming up for the movie. And then, the Quadruplets, going to have an OVA that we were doing last year. And then, of course, this Diamond, like the comments, is going to have like every episode has 30 seconds. I'm looking forward to see how this anime is done. And then, of course, we have some bigger news. One more spot to go. We have for a movie following the epilogue. Since we know that we should be doing it today. We are looking at the website. And I can't wait to see how this epilogue is going. We have seen the last episode. But give you the buzz and what I like. We're going to make a cut.
But you will see ya. And I cannot wait. Kirby, how excited for WrestleMania?
I'm so excited for WrestleMania because you only have like some week one, 6 weeks of WrestleMania, so 6 weeks of the show. Okay, you got all the show coming out in the week one.
And then week two?
And then week two, another 6, and I'm personally excited to see how this all the show going to turn out. We see like their familiar show, like for example, we're going to see, of course, Conor Silva, Season 2, Vale Aragorn, Julia Kaiser, main event, Yelena Bo, make a return, and much more coming up. And I cannot wait to see how does all this shit gonna go. Well, guys, I'm not talking, but right now, let's have a little live watch Frieren Beyond Journeys End from episode 1 to 10 on the regular schedule program. Alright, guys, we here. I am so excited to see people talking about this anime a lot. That this anime is, of course, like this is a masterpiece anime. We heard from what we heard. We see some of the clip about it, but we just don't know what's going to happen the rest of the anime. But guys, look, I cannot wait to see how the anime is going to go. So guys, let's watch Frieren Beyond Journeys End with the first 10 episodes starting with episode 1. So you ready?
Alright, now episode 1 of Frieren Beyond Journeys End. Start now. So, guy,
let's do it.
Here we go.
Wow.
Well, guys, because this is the last main anime before WrestleMania.
Before we hit the weekend. Cold catches so that people could hear while they're there.
Right. Oh, there she is.
It's very end.
Peace can be welcomed in a more perfect way. Beautiful.
The view from inside the city isn't very good.
I'm trying to have a moment here. Don't spoil the mood.
Before I go, let me get a good look. This will likely be the last time that I see you.
Why, are you unwell?
My years of drinking had to catch up with...
I saw that tree earlier. These woods are always quite the labyrinth. Where am I?
You seem a bit lost.
Oh! Oh.
Fred!
Wait.
Is there something you're looking for?
Yes, I'm trying to locate the home of a man named Heiter.
I see. So you're a visitor.
The corrupt priest is slow to die.
Turns out a stylish exit is harder to achieve than I thought.
I brought some liquor to offer to the grave. Would you like a drink?
I gave the stuff up.
Ah. I doubt the goddess will forgive you. You're far too close to corpsehead to clean up your act now.
Why, thank you, kind lady.
Who is she?
Her name is Fern.
Her Fern.
She was orphaned by the wars in the Southern Lands.
Damn. My, how unexpected. I never thought you the type to do charity for charity's sake. That was always Himmel.
Frieren, why did you come visit me?
I had a few errands to run in the Holy City, and I want to learn more about those I have met and will meet on my travels. You've done me much good, so I came here to repay my debts. I imagine your time is running low.
In that case, I have a request.
Mm-hmm.
Might you take on an apprentice? Fern has potential as a mage, but needs adequate training. Will you bring her with you and strengthen her skills?
Forgive me, Heiter, but I must draw a line. She'd only get in my way. We both know how often apprentice mages die in battle. I will not send a child my friend asked me to care for to her death.
Understood. I have another favor in mind.
Huh?
This was unearthed from the tomb of Eivig the Sage. Inside this grimoire, there is said to be a wealth of lost spells with powers ranging from resurrection to immortality.
I find it hard to believe that such magic exists.
That's part of the reason why I'd like you to decipher it. Up for the challenge?
The code is largely symbol-based. The people of this era had a penchant for such things. I'll need at least 5 or 6 years.
Do what you can.
Why do you want these spells deciphered in the first place? Sir, success requires a combination of 3 key factors that are essential to all mages. There's the amount of mana utilized, the strength at which it's fired, and the level of control you have over it. But you know that much, correct?
Yes.
Earlier, your magic dissipated before it reached its target. That tells me your levels of mana and your firing strength are both lacking. These are not issues that one can fix overnight. Regardless of your talent, such skills will take years to master. That said, the level of control you have over your magic is very high.
Yes, it did.
That's the area where most people tend to struggle, but you're already exhibiting great strength there. My advice is to be patient with yourself.
All right.
Is Fern's training coming along smoothly?
In a short 4 years, she's learned more than most do in 10. I don't feel this is a good thing. She is studying too hard.
Perhaps nothing seems to pull her out of the woods. Even so, I'm glad she's found something she loves.
Regardless, she's still a long way from becoming a proper mage. I'll have deciphered the grimoire before she reaches that status.
Oh my god!
Perhaps I missed him as well.
Fern did it!
She found that
Hello. No.
I really can't thank you enough. Without your help and guidance, I couldn't have repaid Master Hyder.
Then you should be thanking him for deceiving me.
You were the bottom.
So long, right? Corrupt priest.
Like you said, from previous.
Well, shall we be off?
Me too.
I thought I would never see it again.
There
it looks beautiful. Thank you for your diligence, Miss Freeman. You've ensured that time will never get the better of the statue again.
Oh, I nearly forgot. There.
Look at that! An adorable touch.
Let's go!
Well, shall we be off?
Oh my god!
Well, we know that this has us destroyed.
Yeah.
So now for training.
Uh-huh. Your defensive training is coming along nicely. Now, let's put your work to the test.
Oh!
Oh wow! It's almost funny. See in hell.
They did it.
Oh shit, we killed him.
Because of you, the quiet village can live in peace once more.
Huh. I've seen that hat.
That could be worse, but
yeah.
I'm glad that this is the... Okay.
Are these for your family? It happened a long time ago. Demons attacked my village and showed no mercy. What are you doing? Praying, of course. We return to nothing when we die. I like to think we go to heaven.
Until several thousand years ago, people largely accepted that nothing comes after. But I know the dwarves value tradition. I myself am skeptical about the idea of a heaven. Magic can't observe the souls of the dead, so an afterlife cannot be outright proven. Though it cannot be disproven either.
I, for one, don't think it matters either way.
I agree. In the grand scheme of things, I can't say how much it truly matters.
Careful now, O corrupt one. Not very priestly.
You're right. But even if a heaven doesn't exist, I very much believe that it should.
Why's that?
I feel it's more convenient that way. Those that kept living despite life's hardships deserve more than just oblivion. Picture the alternative. A heavenly realm where souls can live in luxury. It's a nice thought.
Good point. That is more convenient. Let's pray.
Yes.
He's still here.
Yeah.
Hello there. I thought I'd drop by.
You act as if it hasn't been 30 years.
So, not very long at all, then.
I suppose not. I never thought you would take on an apprentice.
Aizen, I came to see if there's anything I can help you with.
I'm not done here yet. I heard you paid a visit to Hyder before he passed away, and asked him the same thing.
How do you know about that?
Hyder and I rode often.
You're much friendlier than you appear.
Or perhaps you're not friendly enough.
Well, tell me, is there anything we could do? Full basin. This takes me back.
So you've been here before?
Long ago.
Long ago, she says. How long must that be?
Probably in prehistoric times.
Not even I have lived that long. Explain. What are we looking for?
The notes of Flama, the legendary mage.
If you insist. But you know most of our supposed writings are fake.
Not this one. I have a lead from Heiter. He deduced the location from records on Flama, left in a holy city. Her genuine notes are located somewhere in Full Basin. Think back, Freeman. You must remember that.
His research was in depth, quite driven for a corrupt priest. Let's begin. We can start by looking for a giant tree.
A giant tree? That's ridiculous. We're in a forest full of them. Well, I suppose you do have all the time in the world.
Yeah, I do. But Fern doesn't like when I
speak with him. You said you would help me, did you not?
You picked up a few tricks. Where?
I think we both know the answer to that.
I'll do it then. We needed a destination. Though I hate to think I'll be passing through the tundra around the Demon King's castle. Maybe I don't want to go.
This is going to be an uphill battle. She's already dead asleep.
As carefree as ever.
It's so cold.
Sleep waning. Is it really that frigid around the Demon King's castle?
Conquering Indus terrain is no small feat. It's at the northernmost end of the continent. We braved much more than the cold in that place.
I'm sure. It feels a little too quiet. I think she's napped for long enough. Nap time's over. I'm curious what goes through her mind. She's a mystery.
Frieren, you won't be staying in the royal capital?
I'm going to keep traveling.
All by yourself?
It's easier that way.
You're not going to take on an apprentice. A journey is better with someone to talk to.
I fear it would be a waste of time. No matter how much I teach them, they'll surely die.
How cheery. That's not how relationships work.
That's how they work for me. Just consider our adventure. It's taken up less than 1/100th of my life. You should understand, Aizen.
That's enough. No time for such depressing talk. Today is a day for celebration and glee. Let us toast!
It sounds like somebody wants an excuse to drink more.
Was the veil so thin?
The veil was transparent.
The corrupt priest strikes again.
Well, yeah, I try again.
Fern, that elf is a great teacher.
You're right.
You're really not coming with us?
Correct. It's as I told you before. I would only get in your way.
All right.
You remember the path to Ender, don't you?
Yes. We'll go through the Villa region. Then we'll cross Regal Canyon and find the Northern Lands checkpoint.
Forgive me. You have a long journey ahead. It took the four of us 10 years.
I see. So we'll be following the same route you took to the Demon King's castle on your first journey.
We're going to the castle.
Take these words to heart, Frieren. Before long, Frieren will be the one in charge of you. Listen to her and be a good girl. If you don't...
If I don't what?
I'll come back as a ghost and haunt you.
Oh, no!
So just to make certain, you're saying that if I'm a bad girl, you'll pay me a visit after you're gone?
You've grown into quite the sly young lady. Wherever did you pick that up?
I miss Hightower, man.
I take it back.
The best praise.
If you're on your best behavior, then I might be willing to stop by and say hello every now and again.
Corrupted priest. But no, he's a good person.
They should be arriving at the village soon.
That was fast.
I said corrupted priest, that damn priest.
Nothing very important.
But it's a good priest.
Yeah.
Bitch, we're gonna start this watch along way too early to keep this up.
But Mistress Frieren, it's clear the villagers need our help.
You're starting to sound just like Himmel and the others.
The biggest difference between you and me is that I am a good girl.
All right. If you want to help them, we shall. We'll be traveling through the mountain pass either way.
It's so nice to walk around in the nature.
The missing villagers didn't vanish into thin air. Plenty of clues. A generous monster.
There are signs of magic usage all around us.
Yes, indeed. Can you tell what type it was?
Illusion magic. In my book on magical ecology, there's this creature. It uses lifelike illusions to lure in its prey.
The Einsam. It preys exclusively upon people, using craftiness rather than strength to lure in its unsuspecting meals. It tricks its victims with phantoms of the dead.
And they really fall for that?
Who wouldn't want a final moment with their dearly departed?
Hey! Nice kid.
Thankfully for the two of us, the Einsam's illusions aren't a threat to mages who know to look beyond their tricks. They're easily dispersed by high-density mana. Basic offensive magic.
Hightower!
There it is. Phantom of the dead. No problem. Just shoot.
Look at that mage. You've surpassed my wildest dreams, my dear. I decided to come back and say hello. A girl as good as you.
It's high time we go see the real thing. If there's anywhere we might find him, it would be Aureli.
You're right. That's a dragon? I've never seen one in real life.
Look at its nest.
That's an egg. No, treasure! Quiver or two!
I've been after that one for a long time.
That doesn't surprise me. Why is it there, of all places?
Dragons are known to seek out objects infused with magic to build their nests. That's a solar dragon. No doubt it has dined on many an adventurer. Grimoire or otherwise, we should eliminate the beast. Be careful not to destroy the nest.
Great.
Okay. Here we go.
That didn't do anything.
They are very resilient creatures. No choice then.
We run. Gotta go.
We're out of here. Out of here.
Fuck.
Oh no.
Oh, hi there, buddy. How you doing? Oh shit.
Finally lost it. This one's a fast flyer. No aerial battle for us.
I thought I was gonna die right there.
Let's head back that way. If we continue to wear it down, the root will eventually give in. Good point.
Yeah.
Playing tag with dragons is not within a mage's job description.
No.
We'll have to take on another companion.
Oh.
A frontliner?
Yes. You're searching for one, aren't you? In a village near Regal Canyon, you'll find a warrior named Stark. Pick him up on your way into the northern lands. He's my apprentice.
Right. Is he any good? Hard to think there's a dragon here. It's so peaceful.
Tis indeed.
I've been meaning to ask, what sort of spell does that grimoire contain anyway?
One that lets you see through clothes.
Excuse me?
Wait, what?
You really do gather only the strangest of spells, Mistress Frieren.
That is my hobby. But this one is practical, too. Depending on what the user views as clothing, it could reveal hidden weaponry.
May I have a moment of your time?
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Stark would like to meet the two of you.
Oh.
That saves us a fair bit of trouble.
It was 3 years back now. The dragon attacked, nearly destroying the village.
Whoa.
That's when he appeared. The brave Mr. Stark. The dragon was fierce, but our brave hero didn't
win. So,
after a long
start,
the monster flew away.
Damn.
It was a sight to behold. Since that day, he has lived alongside us in the village, and that dragon has been too scared to rear its ugly head ever again. 3 whole years of peace.
Perfect. He sounds like just the person we need. The dragon's done for.
I hope you're right.
Do you think I can be a strong warrior like you?
Sure you can.
There
but
he is.
Even warrior's rougher than it looks.
Yeah. New priest, new people.
Huh? It's Grandma!
Hey, Mr. Stark, how you doing?
Tony Stark.
So you're the ones who've been messing with the dragon. Don't get that thing too worked up. You'll put the whole village in danger. Dragons are serious. They're not the fairy tale creatures you think they are. One of them gave me the scar. I was fighting a shadow dragon.
That's child's play as far as injuries go.
My master put you up to this, didn't he? Who are you?
I am known as Frieren the Mage.
Hey, Gran, mind giving us some privacy? It's all right. They're acquaintances of my master. Don't hold back. He must be furious. I left without so much as a word.
Stark, you have no reason to remain in this village. Why haven't you defeated the dragon?
Tell me what you want and maybe I'll think about sharing. If you're here to send me back to my master, you can forget about it.
We're in need of a warrior. Would like for you to join us. Though before that, we would appreciate your help in defeating the dragon.
Our warning is what made this fissure.
Yeah! Stark!
I see now. Your training is what made this fissure.
That's a shame. I had high hopes for the lad. We're left with no choice. Prepare yourself for dragon-sized tag.
Frieren.
Okay.
Stark.
You only need 30 seconds, right?
You took your time.
I want you to promise me one thing. If I die fighting this dragon, you have to finish it off for me.
So Star has joined the party.
Yep.
There is monster activity in the northern lands. A this time, no one can pass through the checkpoint.
Well, at what time can we? It has to open someday.
Does it? It hasn't since I was very first posted here. After all, no people out means no monsters in.
Pardon me. The Castellan would like to see you, sir.
Be right there. Listen close, adventurers. You would be wise not to cause any trouble in this town.
That wasn't a very warm welcome.
He's a good guard. Wants to keep his people safe. And is appropriately harsh on outsiders. As every proper town guard ought to be, in my opinion.
Do you want people to be dead if you're a monster?
Speaking of safety, this city seems to have it in spades, which is a positive of being stuck here. This is the perfect time to slow down and study our craft. Once we drop off our things, the magic shops are all mine. Come now. The checkpoint is locked tight. We have no other choice. Run along. You're free to roam. I'll secure us a room at the inn.
Still there.
You want to get something to eat? Loud and clear. Scary.
Bitch. Oh.
Rumor is they shut down the sea routes too.
The Northern Lands Army says they'll take care of the problem, but I give it 2 years until the checkpoint opens up again. Business is at a standstill.
I haven't had this in forever. The Jumbo Berry Special. I was just a kid when I came here last. I actually had to split it with my master because I couldn't finish it alone. But, I feel like this thing has shrunk.
I would know. It's the same size as ever. You've simply grown up.
I suppose age does change our perception. Everything seemed huge when I was a kid. I used to think my master's back was so broad. But even that started to look small.
Aizen is getting up there in years. I hope you're being a dutiful student.
Duty is what brought me here. You sure the portion's the same?
The passage of time is cruel.
That's fine.
Oh, it's fine.
You've got no reason to glare at me. I bought this with my own money.
Pardon me. One milk, please.
Sure thing.
Clearly mad.
Mr. Stark.
Fine, I guess you can have half.
Age?
No, books supposedly attributed to Flama are never real. Every tome uncovered so far has been a fabrication. This is probably the best imitation I've come across over the years, though. It's not a terrible reward to receive for defeating monsters.
If you say so, I don't see the appeal.
What a shame. When you find nothing but forgeries, you start to doubt whether the genuine article ever existed in the first place.
The great Flama, founder of humanity's magic. To be fair, it's like a fairy tale.
Is that what people believe? I suppose. Good morning.
It's a miracle! She woke up early!
Hey!
Shocked by that?
Astounded. This is deserving of a reward.
What is that? My most humble thanks. When I saw this landslide, I feared I would never find a way through the pass. Hey, is this actually necessary?
Are you unhappy? He's offered a fine reward.
No, that's not the issue. This would go faster if you just used your magic to move his cart.
But what of future travelers? We'd be stuck here. That's what Fern said. We wouldn't want to be selfish, now, would we?
That's rage coming from you. I insist you have a drink.
Oh, thanks. That'd be great. It's strange. I thought landslides happened on a bigger scale.
The northern lands have been fighting demons in this area, and their clashes have had a far-reaching impact on local terrain. This was likely caused by such a skirmish.
So now we're tending to the scars of battle.
Mr. Stark, would you mind helping me over here? I could use your assistance for a moment. Mr. Stark?
Hey, could you maybe drop the Mr. part? Stark is fine. It weirds me out. I'm pretty sure we're close to the same age.
Very well. If you prefer it. Stark, you're wasting everyone's time. Help me.
I just meant that if we can go on this journey together, you can drop the formalities. We can talk to each other casually. And it wouldn't hurt you to be a little friendlier, you know? I'm a warrior with a sensitive soul.
What a pain in the rear.
Why'd you call me?
I assume you're making good progress.
You heard her. Let's hurry, Mr. Stark.
Wow! Okay.
You have my undying gratitude. If you'd like, I can show you the fastest route into town. I have the honor of escorting an elf, eh? I've lived for many decades, but this is my first time meeting one of your kind.
I suppose we are a rarity.
Huh. Now that I'm thinking about it, you're the only one I've ever seen in person, too.
There aren't very many of us. In fact, I've only ever met a handful of other elves in all my travels. We may live a long time, but we've scattered to the winds. Of course, it doesn't help that we don't have romantic urges or reproductive instincts. We're experiencing a quiet extinction. Over 400 years have gone by since I've laid eyes on another elf. We may be close to disappearing.
This is a lovely view of the town. It's a busy day at the gate.
Those look like marching wagons.
The Liberation Festival is tonight. It was on this very day many moons ago that Himmel and his party of heroes defeated the demons who plagued this land.
That must have been quite the experience for them.
The Liberation Festival commemorates their triumph. Every year, the statues of Mr. Himmel and his companions in the central plaza are decorated, and the town throws a grand celebration around them.
Humans love to make a fuss. They'll use any excuse to hold a festival.
More than 80 years have passed since the demons were finally defeated on that auspicious day. That's plenty of time for even something so important to begin fading from the minds of men. But we can't have that. And so we celebrate, in remembrance of those who fought on our behalf.
Okay.
Excellent work.
The fifth time's a charm. This sculptor worked faster than previous ones.
You are constantly getting statues put up in your honor, Himmel.
Well, how else can I assure that people will remember us? Our lives are fleeting compared to yours. We won't be around for long.
Take a look at this face. Future generations must see how handsome I was.
Whatever.
You may just walk away.
Though, there is a greater reason. When we three are gone, maybe our statues will keep you from feeling lonely.
Come again?
You'll know we existed. That we aren't just fairy tales, but people who stood beside you.
Every year, we gather in celebration of the spectacular deeds accomplished by this brave band of heroes. Now that we're here, I must say that you bear a striking resemblance to Miss Frieren, that mighty mage of yore.
Will they still be doing this 100 years from now?
Oh, yes. For as long as this town stands.
1,000 years?
That's more difficult to foresee.
Well, shall we be off?
told me what our final destination is yet. Where are we going?
To heaven.
Oh my god.
It then is forbidden to guests. Why are you here? Please, return to...
Wow!
Shit. Small snap and then...
How'd they come late?
Sorry, I'm told visiting hours are over.
I'm an executioner named Strat. I serve Aura at the guillotine. Oh, shit. Don't fight. I have come here to kill you.
I see. Not pretending you want peace anymore?
We've just begun. According to Lord Lugnia, this girl is the only obstacle standing in our way. If I dispose of her now, and we get Graf Granat to trust us, this town will crumble.
I should warn you that I am fairly strong.
Stronger than me?
Stronger even than our... Sorry, I'm told visiting hours are over.
I'm an executioner named Strat. I serve Aura the guillotine. Don't fight. I have come here to kill you.
I see. Not pretending you want peace anymore?
We've just begun.
I should warn you that I am fairly strong.
Stronger than me?
Stronger even than Aura the guillotine.
I doubt that very much.
Why?
Oh!
Why? For this fight is already over.
Magical wire, huh?
Whoa.
What an interesting spell.
You concentrated mana around your neck to avoid decapitation. You're level-headed. Which allowed you to keep your head when an ordinary mage would have lost theirs. Try what you will, but this wire is among demonkind's strongest spells. Humanity's feeble magic doesn't stand a chance.
Oh!
I should saw through your mana and the soft pink flesh underneath.
You're right. I doubt there is anything I can do to sever your thread. Really? That's all it took to convince you you'd won? Demons these days are such a disgrace. No experience on the battlefield.
Wait, what?
This mage. She took my
arm.
Oh! Over the head. Oh!
Let's talk this through!
Oh!
Yo!
Yo!
That's one beast down.
Don't mess with Frieren, man!
Oh.
If I report this attack to the Goth and exterminate the rest of the town's parasites, a pardon is the least he could grant me.
Wow!
Good shit, Frieren. You killed a bastard. Oh, yeah, about that?
Yeah.
This is going to cost
you.
We are but wild beasts. But don't worry. I won't kill you. You're going to assist us in removing this town's defensive barrier.
He's a blow on the sword.
Shouldn't be too much farther from here.
Shit. Huh? Frieren!
Frieren!
Frieren, my ass. It's Frieren.
That is you, isn't it?
Yeah, it's Frieren. Well,
Harry Fogg.
Aren't you supposed to be in jail? Please don't tell me that you broke out.
I didn't have a choice in the matter. A demon called Drat came into my cell trying to execute me. And though I took care of the issue, when demons die, they turn into mana particles and vanish.
I don't understand the connection.
Before visiting me, he killed the man guarding the dungeon. To better paint the scene, all to be found down there was a guard beheaded by a magical wire, and a lone mage. So where might that put me?
You'll be sentenced to death for killing the guard.
I think so too. Which is why I have no choice but to leave town.
Wait a moment. If you leave, the remaining demons will run wild. Would you really abandon these people?
Why don't you two defeat them for me?
You make it sound like an everyday chore.
You don't stand a chance in a fight against monsters like them.
You're not going to fight them just because they're strong. Don't look so downcast. I've fought more than my fair share of demons, and you're no weaker than they are.
Okay, we'll fight them, but you've got to help us. You can't ask us to go it alone. We're begging you.
Where do you think you're going? You can't leave us to die. You don't know when to give
up. Steal your resolve, remember? Steal yourself. I don't want
to be being bullied. You're being challenged.
Now I feel before for fear, man.
Yeah.
So she got like fame, but she didn't kill a guard. You wait till the demon is dead and make
about
her look like she killed
a guard. Outside of Tim, I sense a great deal of mana. Someone is observing us. Aura the Guillotine, one of the seven sages of destruction. It isn't as if I enjoy facing powerful enemies either. All the more reason to take care of this one swiftly.
Enemy combat.
Yeah. It's good to have some warm water and then while it's not to swim. I forgot this part.
This feels wrong. You're sure we have to sneak in?
Well, I suppose we could just tell the gate guards we're here to kill the peace envoys.
To humanity's analysis of Zoltrak, and sent more demons to the grave than anyone else in history. Frieren the Slayer. One of the geniuses I despise. It's important that you rest for the time being.
I appreciate it.
Oh, God.
Whoa, there!
Oh, easy, man.
You doing okay?
I will survive, but only because of you two. I'm grateful. I'll pardon your companion for her actions as well. She was right to take a stand when she did.
Which means nothing stopping Frieren from coming back. The peace envoy's as good as dead.
Also, please know that Mistress Frieren didn't kill your guard.
I am aware. The demons are to blame for that, too. More importantly, you said this woman's name's Frieren?
Yes.
Which almost certainly makes her the elven mage who adventured with the hero. I've committed a grave discourse.
To make you suffer.
Magic. Designed to kill.
The kill guy. That was a safe fight. What now? Oh, fuck.
Llama? You mean master.
This is the backstory.
What is it? Do you really think the way you dealt with them was unfair?
A master.
Frieren, do you remember Basalt's final words before he perished? Why would I bother? Their kind only uses words to deceive. Smart girl. They are nothing more than monsters that can imitate the human tongue. I call them demons, and take it from an expert, they are all the same. They don't play fair, so we have no choice but to take their lead and deceive doubly so. If this could be the secret to exterminating their species, then I will gladly embrace the dishonor it entails.
This is the end.
It would seem your plan has failed rather badly.
Yes, perhaps. But Frieren won't make it out unscathed. By this hour, I'm sure she and Lady Aura have begun to clash. Decades ago, we were forced to retreat by the party of heroes. But this time, she has no heroes to hide behind. I do admit your ally poses a threat to us. But her mana is no match for my lady's. If Frieren attacks her head-on, she'll most certainly lose the fight.
In that case, I have no doubt my mistress will win. She would never directly engage a demon, especially not one that's so powerful. She'll kill Aura by tricking her.
Nonsense. I know this mage. Frieren the Slayer has never once fought us from the shadows. Why, then, do I feel something is wrong? This girl's mana is weak. Yet I was overwhelmed by the sheer number of her rapid attacks. How was she able to execute such powerful magic without exhausting her mana? I see. Is such a thing even possible? So Frieren does the same. Too afraid to fight fair. Both you and your teacher are a disgrace to the title of mage.
I assure you, Mistress Frieren knows that better than anyone else.
Finish.
We did it. Come on, eat that.
What horrors await today? This is an elven village.
Wait a minute.
Basalt the Throne. A general of the Demon King's army. He must have led his forces here to destroy this town. Speak up, girl. Was it you who killed him? You look near dead yourself.
Frieren.
Frieren.
Good bit of mana you have there. You must be powerful. You took them head on, didn't you? A brute in disguise. That was a foolish mistake.
So
I don't know why people prefer an honest playing field. Run or hide or take them by surprise.
That's sweet.
You're working both safer and smarter if you do. I can't understand the way strong mages think. Well, you should.
That's a hole.
Huh? You should understand exactly how I think. I'm certain
the aura is strong.
You are far more powerful a mage than I.
She's stronger than Fauna. Oh god, bro.
And what makes you say that? Call it a hunch. Interesting. Have a name?
Damn.
What happened to the village? Its people are dead. Not even the women and children were spared. I couldn't save them. Being their strongest didn't do me any good. Trying to save them at all was silly. If it were me, one side of those monsters would have sent me for the hills. Put me down. No. You have potential. You're going to be my apprentice. Don't forget I saved your life. If I hadn't shown up, you would be sharing a grave with that demon.
You failed to protect your village and nearly yourself. You would have died in vain. But luckily, I was there to assist.
This show looks so good, man. I love it, George.
Yes.
These are stronger than the general you killed.
Oh, what the fuck?
Fascinating creatures, aren't they? They fully intended to catch us off guard by consuming your mind just before they struck. But the moment they realized we were mages, they waltzed out into the open with grandeur. They are cunning and they never play fair. But every last one of them has a ridiculous sense of pride when it comes to magic.
Shit.
You may leave, human mage. Once you put down the elf girl, that is. And you'll let me go free if I do as you say. Massacre the elves, now. Those were the Demon King's orders. Your existence matters not to me. How thoughtful. Frieren, you were right before. I'm painfully aware of how a powerful mage thinks. Much like I'm aware of how these creatures think. I know the absolute faith they have in these magics they've poured their lives into studying. In other words, I know they're an arrogant and overconfident breed.
Oh!
Whoa!
Whoa. Jesus Christ!
They lacked your perception and quickly judged me a weakling.
Yeah.
I admit they were exceptional mages. Their overconfidence cost them their lives. By controlling the release of your mana, you hid your strength so they didn't see you as a threat. That's right.
Narwhal.
I deceived and killed my enemies by allowing them to miscalculate my power. It is a cowardly and unfair way to fight that makes a mockery of the art of magic itself.
My teacher likes to do that.
Exactly.
And there she is.
Your injuries are looking much better. I'd say it's time we begin your training. Plum, you mean master. The demons took all that I've ever known from me. Me too. I wish to eradicate every last one. Me too. But I love magic and hold great respect for it. You and I are the same. That's why we should be the only ones who can make a mockery of it. Protect it through cowardice. What do you suppose I should do to train? Try limiting the mana you release to 1/10 of its typical volume. Impressive. You're controlling it well. I imagine any elf could do something so simple. While you do that, you'll spend time on fundamentals. Work to raise the base of your mana. Is that really all? Easy enough. Do I stop suppressing my mana whenever I feel like it, or whenever you tell me to? It'll get tiring if I do it for too long. You'll do it for as long as I have. For life. If you can, you'll fool demonkind for the rest of your days.
Now this is what happened.
I sense Lord Lugnir's dead.
Slaughtered like the rest of your executioners. Do you see your failure, Aura?
That I do. Tis a shame indeed. However, if I defeat you here and now, their sacrifice won't have been for naught. At the beginning of our skirmish, you made it your priority to release as many immortal soldiers from my control as you could. All that work cost you. Was it wise to expend so much of your mana right in front of me?
The scales of obedience. When two souls are placed opposite each other, whichever has more mana forces the other to submit. Only someone with as much mana as Aura could handle this sort of risky magic so casually. Generally speaking, a person's mana increases in proportion to time spent training. I can feel it in the power pouring off her. She's a great demon who has lived for over 500 years.
and has spent the majority of that time training. 500 years. That's fairly long lived for her kind. I doubt she's been challenged before. I can tell that much from mana overflowing from her body. She has no tricks up her sleeve, as demons don't conceal their mana. They can't afford to. I pity you.
Auxilisa.
Oh, shit.
Master? Demons are quite cunning creatures, are they not? So why haven't they thought to constantly suppress their mana like you do?
I'm sure they would if they could. Demons are individualists by nature, but form the frailest connections needed to stand a chance against humankind. The barest society needs what to function?
Order, I suppose.
That's right. Even an organization of monsters needs someone of importance to lead it. Humans need the same. Importance is determined by status and wealth. In our world, those who have both get to rule. Look at that well-dressed fellow leaving the palace. He's clearly important. But humans have no innate way of showing that. So, for others to know he's someone of note, he has to put on the trappings of rank.
So demons are different, then?
Despite their performance of civilization, demons haven't changed a bit since beasthood. Might makes right. Far more straightforward than us humans. You can tell who's strong by looking at them.
Through their mana?
Mana is everything to their kind, much like status and wealth are to ours. It's dignity itself. Now there is a chance they may temporarily suppress their mana for the sake of stealth, but never foolish enough to forfeit their standing to constantly suppress their power. It's the difference between a noble sneaking out into town in disguise and that same noble debasing themselves by abandoning their station entirely. Demons know nothing of charity and would never grant dignity to those with little mana. Their world is a cold and cruel one. So, the stronger an individual is, the more desperate they are to show it off. Unlike us, for them there's no benefit in constantly suppressing their mana. The thought doesn't so much as cross their minds. In a way, I pity them, just as we are bound by the places we live and the clothing we can afford. Demons are bound by mana. Magic is the very lifeblood of their species, but for all their unrivaled love for it, the poor fools can't even control their mana. Frieren, you're very lucky you aren't a demon.
I know I am. I couldn't deceive them if I were.
It's been 3 years since you began suppressing your mana. I suppose I was right about you after all.
Meditation.
You've grown much better at that.
Oh my god.
You still love magic, don't you? That was rather out of the blue, Master.
Your has it changed.
Yeah.
But yes, somewhat.
Your confidence has waned over time. Long ago, you told me you loved the craft with fervor.
It's only been 50 years since then.
That's what I got. Alphaway's
a smart girl.
Yeah.
Not rare, but interesting.
All this time, and the only thing I've taught my apprentice to do is fight. Magic fit for revenge.
Is that something you regret?
Not a bit. No one's better suited to hold on to the secrets of my magic than you. You're going to live a long life. Perhaps someday you'll become strong enough to defeat the Demon King. Frieren, I do have one request.
What is it?
All I ask is that you plant flowers around my grave.
That doesn't seem like you.
I know. Frieren, I have a spell that creates a field of flowers. To tell you the truth, it's actually my favorite one. My parents taught it to me when I was a girl. It's what made me fall in love with magic.
And I'd like you to teach it to me.
Listen to me, Frieren. You must never seek to leave your mark on history. There's safety in obscurity. And once you've finally defeated the Demon King, rest assured the whole world shall know your name.
his paw now.
God, why do anime so... Why did this anime sad, bro?
You see, like, when people were very, they pass away.
Yeah.
It was heartbroken.
Whoa.
Oh, walking out.
See, the first time I saw it, man.
Yeah, ever since.
We lost Hero, we lost Hightower. There.
Now we're final.
Yeah. Surprisingly, like, Hayes is still alive.
Yeah.
Dude, I thought he was gone. Like, with all of this journey. But no, it's still there. Oh, hold on!
I've heard a seasoned mage lives somewhere in these woods. Is that mage you?
Seasoned in the sense I've been around
for. They just met her!
Precious little with my years. I'm in no way exceptional.
What do you think, Hunter? I would say she has approximately one-fifth of the mana I do. Fairly middle of the road.
Way to make a first impression. Now move along. You don't have business with a mediocre mage, do you?
No, but you're easily the strongest mage I've ever laid eyes on.
And what would make you say that?
Call it a hunch.
Happy with yourself. Are you so certain you'll win, Aura?
We'll find out soon enough. Frieren the Slayer. It's been 80 years since you made your first meaningful appearance in this world. With the party of heroes, you defeated the Demon King. It makes one wonder just how long you've had to study your magic. Unfortunately for you, it matters not how many years you've managed to survive. Your mana tells me everything I need to know. I can see it clearly. There is no question you're an exceptional mage, but your mana itself is unimpressive. I would wager you've had no more than 100 years training. Not only that, it's been 80 years and you haven't grown a bit. Were you honing other skills instead of increasing your mana? Or were you piddling your life away? Just as expected, you're absolutely no match for me. As you can see, I win. I shall consider it an honor to sever the head of the Slayer myself. I'm shocked that it wasn't even necessary to exhaust her mana. I needn't have been so cautious. Though she did defeat a decent amount of my troops. I'll have to replenish them later.
Wait.
What's this?
The scales
are starting to tip in her
direction. Oh!
Yeah! You're the one who opted to gamble with my soul, Aura. To tell you the truth, I would have been in real trouble if you had tried to overwhelm me with numbers. I'm grateful for your overconfidence when it comes to your mana. Now I can finally defeat you.
Wait, huh?
But can you now?
You really should have figured it out. I've been suppressing your mana.
You're going down!
A grave miscalculation on your part, Aura.
Valiant last-ditch effort. But there's no chance that could have escaped my notice. There wasn't a hint of the instability or variation in your mana output that comes with suppression.
I'm surprised. Demons are capable of observing mana with such accuracy. Seems my master was right in her methods after all. I've spent the better part of my life in a constant state of suppression. It has become natural for me.
You're dimmer than I thought. Why would you ever do something so foolish?
Foolish, yes. You're powerful. It lets me defeat your kind.
This is absurd. I'm a great demon who has lived for over 500 years.
Aura, the for over 1,000.
Yo! That's a mana! Her mana's huge!
Very.
Oh, Frieren! Oh! Whoa!
Just as demons deceive mankind with their words, you must deceive them with your mana. Aura, kill yourself.
What? Oh!
No. Oh, no!
This can't be. No. How could I ever?
Like I said, do not mess with Frieren.
Do not mess with Frieren, man. Oh! No, guys, give us a round of applause.
Frieren fucking kill her.
Okay, so here's the thing. Stark and Fern have stole the show. Okay, congrats with them. But Frieren is just the beginning. Because I know later on it's going to happen. So, guys, here's the deal. Tomorrow we're gonna watch along. However, Easter Sunday Resurrect is coming tomorrow at 6 p.m. Well, special starts at 6 p.m. Eastern and then 3 p.m. Pacific. But Monday, we're coming back with a watch along on the first day in April. No, guys, no April 4th. No, we're not joking because we're gonna be watching at least 13 episodes of Frieren Beyond Journey End. And then on Tuesday, we're going to be watching at least the last few episodes of it. And after that, we're going to be watching the second main event, the second last main event of Solo Lover. And the main event is the Danger of My Heart. God, this anime actually surpassed everyone's expectation. This journey and everything, it built up. And God, we have a lot more to go. So God, we'll see you guys tomorrow. Oh, sorry, we'll see you on Monday. But tomorrow, make sure to watch the event because you don't want to miss some action-packed matches. Like, for example, Neo with the Fantasy Sting was on the championship against Sonic. And then, we know the main event was where Kurt was going to win his YouTube championship against his wife, Lucina. And God, we're looking forward to see how the match is going to go.
I cannot wait. Either side of the right is the East. Tomorrow is like my favorite holiday of the year. Easter, I'm so excited coming up, ladies and gentlemen. We don't know. We see you guys tomorrow for Easter Resurrect. And then Monday, we're going back to Watch Along for Wash. Continue watching Frieren Beyond Journey End. Tell them.
All 13 episodes, and then Tuesday, we watch the last few. And then after that, we watch the Solo by Danger of My Heart.
I said that, guys. We see you guys tomorrow for Easter Resurrect. And then Monday for Watch Along. Tell them. Hope you have a happy Easter. And make sure you guys save. Also, pray for Jesus, because Easter is tomorrow, so make sure you have fun. Good night, guys, and happy Easter from Tico Sober.